intensive, Dr. Sachdev, is a cataract surgery, the procedure itself?
Okay, so if I say, if we look at cataract surgery, there have been phenomenal advances in cataract surgery. Cataract surgery actually started out of India. That is India's, I would say, then to the world, and that is Shushrut. Shushrut was the person who started cataract surgery by a simple procedure called as couching. So cataract, the center of the eye and the pupil through which the light is going, there is a cataractous lens there. So what he did was they put a needle there and he would dislocate or throw back the lens within the eye. So this pupil then became clear. Instead of a, like a curtain here, the curtain would be into one. That was what Shushrut did. And thereon the cataract surgery have evolved. Significant evolution since maybe even when we were doing our post-graduation, that that time there was an intracapsular cataract surgery where the entire lens was removed in one go, or it was in a single piece. And then the patient was given thick soda glass, like lenses, old movies you might have seen, 10+10 power lenses that were worn outside in the glasses,
right,
which obviously didn't give good quality of work. So there have been bifold, I would say, improvement in the technique and technology of cataract surgery. The first thing is that the cataract is not removed en bloc as a single piece. Now the cataract is broken up into small little pieces with the power of laser or something called as phacoemulsification. We crush the cataract into small pieces and suck it out through a small incision.
Okay.
So the incision has shrunk from a larger incision, which was say maybe which was covering half the eye from the from 0 to 180 degree. It has now shrunk to only 2 or 2.2 millimeters.
Okay.
So this incision, because you have broken or pulverized the lens, you have emulsified the lens. The word that is used is phacoemulsification. Phaco means lens, emulsification means to break it into small pieces. So you are able to suck it out through a small incision. Now this small incision is self-sealing. It's like a pressure cooker. So if you can push out the thing, but it, when it closes, it seals. So the surgery has now become, not that we are using any general anesthesia in these cases. Earlier the surgeries were done under general anesthesia. Even today, say in England, some places they are still doing under general, but we are now doing it under. Then it went on to giving an injection around the eye to make the eye immobile. Now we are doing it just by drop anesthesia.
Okay.
That means you are just putting anesthetic drops onto the eye and the patient is supposed to look at the microscope. It has totally become a microscopic surgery. It has therefore, under topical anesthesia, we are doing the surgery. So this is no stitch, no injection, no patch, walk-in, walk-out kind of a surgery. So that's the kind of dimensions it has been changed, that you can today do a cataract surgery by taking drop anesthesia. It takes about 10 to 15 minutes and you crush the cataract into small pieces, suck it out. And from where you have sucked out the cataract, you are putting an artificial lens, which is called as an intraocular lens, so the person doesn't have to wear thick glasses. So that is what the procedure is, and the highest pinnacle that is there after phacoemulsification or microincision cataract surgery is what is called as femto-laser assisted cataract surgery. So with the help of a laser, which is called as a femto-laser, we are doing certain steps of the cataract, then which makes it more precise, more accurate, and the outcomes are much more better, and it is more gentle on the eye.
Thank you, Dr. Sachdev, for elaborating so well on how the surgery happens. And what about post-surgery? How is the visual rehabilitation post-surgery?
Earlier, when the cataract surgery was done and there was a larger incision, people were put in sandbags, like your head, there were no sutures at that time, etc. So there was an incision so that the internal parts of the eye don't come out. So the patient was supposed to be immobile and the heads were not moving. Therefore, typically these surgeries were not done in monsoons or in summers, etc., etc. But now, as I told you, that the incision has shrunk to about 2 millimeters or 2.2 millimeters. There is no stitch, etc. required. There are no irritation, etc. The eye looks pretty white. That means that there isn't any congestion, redness, etc. the next day. And typically, barring some unforeseen circumstances, the patient recovers a lot of vision within 24 hours or within few hours of the surgical procedure. There is no bed rest that is required, so you can go ahead and you can kind of resume your normal activities within a day or two, etc. But the post-operative, you have to put certain eye drops, which are there from 4 to 6 weeks. rehabilitated glasses, whatever little amount that is required, if at all, are normally given at 2 to 3 weeks postoperatively. But there is, it's reasonably, lot of people have resumed their activities the next day or the day after. So that's the kind of speed at which the visual rehabilitation is happening, and the no need for immobilization or putting the patient to bed is there.
Follow Center for Sight and post your queries to get answers from the experts.